Hey everyone, in this video I want to give you a detailed walkthrough of my new drum creation tool for Ableton Live called DRUMR. If you're wanting to get just a brief intro to DRUMR, there's a separate shorter video that you can watch. I'll put the link in the description. In this video, I'm going to take a detailed look at DRUMR, what it is, how you can use it in your own music, and exactly what each of the controls do and how you can use them to create interesting drum sounds. So once you've downloaded DRUMR, you'll have the DRUMR.zip file, which you can unzip to get the DRUMR folder. Inside the folder, there are a couple different files, and it's important that you don't move any of these out of this folder because you can run into issues where samples get unlinked. So make sure that whatever you do, you keep this entire folder intact, but you can move this folder to anywhere on your hard drive. So if you've got somewhere that you store your own presets, you can move DRUMR to that location, or you could add it to Live's user library or hit the add folder button to add it to your places. Inside this folder, there is a DRUMR rack and a folder of presets. Now, the intention behind DRUMR is for you to discover your own interesting drum sounds. So these presets are only included to give you an idea of some of the sounds that you can get with DRUMR and the kinds of settings you'd set up to get those sounds. So obviously you're more than welcome to use these presets in your music, but what you really want to focus on is the DRUMR device over here, because this is the base raw blank DRUMR device that you're going to be using to create new drum sounds. So we can load this up onto a track in Live, and we could have it on its own track, but DRUMR is actually designed to work with drum racks. So we're going to load up a blank drum rack and rather load DRUMR onto one of the pads within our drum rack. So because DRUMR works with drum racks, you can very easily mix and match it with anything else that'll go in a drum rack, with samples, with other drum circuits, if you've used my Earth drum circuits, and with various different instances of DRUMR to even create entire drum kits out of different instances of DRUMR. DRUMR works by manipulating some frequency-rich source samples to create drum sounds. Now, these source samples aren't actually drum hits. What I found when I was creating DRUMR and sort of exploring some of the options is that what actually works a lot better is longer drone texture noise sounds, because these give us a lot of frequencies and textures to work with for creating various different interesting drum sounds. And you'll see how that's going to play out in a moment. So these two controls here allow us to adjust those bass samples. The first one lets us choose which of those bass samples we are using, and there's a couple included. And you can immediately hear how certain samples are going to work for particular drum sounds, but really a lot of these samples are very versatile and will work for various different kinds of drum sounds. The second control allows us to scroll within the sample. Because these are longer drone and texture samples, they have slightly evolving textures throughout the sample. So you can use the sample position control to play the sample at different points and create slight variations in your drum texture. Now, at the moment, you'll hear that that's very subtle, but where this starts to really have an impact is after we've adjusted some of these other controls. So we're going to come back to the sample position setting, and you'll see how even making very small adjustments to this control can have fairly big results. Our decay control is fairly self-explanatory. That just controls the decay of our sound. So we'd have a short decay for things like hi-hats and claves, and maybe a longer decay for things like boomy kick drums or cymbals. Pitch controls the pitch of our sample. Turning it to the left will lower the pitch, and to the right will raise the pitch. Now, the next two controls work together, And I find this is really where the magic happens with DRUMR, and they can be a little bit counterintuitive at first. What they are is a high pass control and the resonance for that high pass. So our high pass cuts out some of our low frequencies. And the HP boost essentially controls the resonance of that high pass. But when we use these two controls in conjunction, we can bring out various resonances from the samples to create different kinds of sounds. For example, we might set our high pass quite low to bring out some low frequency resonances for a kick drum. And we might set it quite high to bring out some higher resonances for a clave. The drive control just applies some overdrive to our sound, which can be good for claps and snares. And then the volume control just lets us adjust the overall output volume, because sometimes when you're adjusting these other controls, it can get a little bit loud. So let's actually create some drum sounds and see how all of these controls can combine together to get some pretty interesting results. So let's start off with a kick drum. Generally, I'll start by setting my source sample and find something that's going to work nicely for what I'm going for. So that sample's probably not really going to work very well for a kick drum. That one should be okay. Next, I'll adjust my pitch because I want to get a bit of a lower pitch for a kick drum. Now I can start to use my high pass control to bring out some of the resonances to start getting a bit more low frequencies in my kick drum. Maybe apply a bit of drive, give it a bit more punch. I'll need to start turning my volume down a bit. And already we're starting to get a kick drum sound. I can adjust my decay. And now you'll see if I start making adjustments to this sample position control, it's going to vary my sound a lot more than it did before. And even making very small adjustments to this control can have quite a big difference. That sounds pretty good for a kick drum. So let's go for our next sound. Let's maybe go for a clap. And what I find works quite nicely with DRUMR is you can actually just hold down Alt to copy the pad. And this serves as a good starting point for creating our next drum sound. So for our clap, we probably want to remove a lot more of the low frequencies. And already it's starting to sound a bit like a clap. We can maybe open up our decay. Maybe increase our pitch. Take out a bit of the resonance. Maybe let's try a different sample. So that's starting to sound a little bit like a clap. Again, let's create a copy of this. And let's go for a hi-hat this time. It's going to be quite easy to get a clap into a hi-hat. Remove a little bit more of the low frequencies. Maybe take out a bit of resonance. We can actually just turn our decay down, and it already starts to sound a bit like a hi-hat. Maybe adjust our pitch, and even try a different source sample. So that's working quite nicely for a hi-hat. And what you'll notice with DRUMR is once you've got some basic settings going for the kind of sound you want, you can start adjusting the sample select and sample position controls to start getting some interesting variations to your sounds. Certain samples and settings might not have as much of a noticeable difference when you adjust the sample position control. So hopefully this has given you some kind of idea of how you can use DRUMR and what all of the controls do, and you'll find that it's a really, really versatile device for coming up with very interesting drum sounds that you probably never would have thought of. And you might come up with conventional sounds like claps and hi-hats and claves, but they'll have slightly different textures to what you would have otherwise come up with just basic samples. So if there are any questions or you want to know more about DRUMR and some of the controls, please post them in the comments below and I'll be sure to get back to you as soon as I possibly can. If you haven't got it already, you can download DRUMR completely for free from my website, which is elephant, elphnt.co.za/DRUMR, DRUMR. So go have a look, check it out and give it a go. And let me know your thoughts in the comments as well. I'd love to hear about what you think of DRUMR. Thanks for watching.